Mr. O'Toole.
Mr. Speaker, it's good to see our parliamentary democracy back in action. The government is spending billions of dollars in this health and economic crisis. Much of that is needed to preserve jobs and help Canadians, but much of the support has been too slow and has made the economic crisis worse. One group of Canadians missed entirely has been our seniors. They're on fixed income. They're our most vulnerable. They're unable to work, and they've seen skyrocketing prices for drugs and food. Why did the government choose to give billions of dollars to groups that may help seniors rather than an immediate OAS supplement to help them immediately?
The Honourable Minister.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. And we recognize that OAS and GIS are an important part of the retirement income Canadians, particularly lower income and rural seniors. Our government is committed to ensuring that during this COVID-19 pandemic, seniors will continue to receive without interruption the benefits to which they are entitled to. We are looking into the ways that we can support seniors during this very difficult time, and we are also working with partners to help deliver services on the ground.
Mr. Speaker, a few weeks ago, the Prime Minister confirmed the temporary closure of our country's borders, including Roxham Row, and he recently allowed the resumption of illegal passage here. Can he confirm that national security and the border should be fully closed? We can't do this, make this a half measure. The government made choices that were against the health of Canadian public. He made ideological choices. When will the Prime Minister close our borders for real? The Honourable Minister.
Unfortunately, in the question, the member opposite is simply misinformed. And in fact, we implemented very strict reciprocal arrangements with the United States to turn back all irregular migrants crossing our border during this particular medical crisis. During the month of April, not a single person crossed, for example, at Roxham Road. And I believe what the member is referring to is the application of the Safe Third Country Agreement, an agreement that has been in place between Canada and the United States since 2004, and its application at points of entry. Mr. Speaker, no one has entered this country illegally at all during any point in time since the implementation of these new measures.
Mr. O'Toole.
Mr. Speaker, the minister just said that we're going to stop illegal crossings just for this health crisis. Will he confirm to this House that after the planking of the curve, they will immediately allow the illegal crossings to continue?
The Honourable Minister.
Thank you. Let me be very clear. What I said is that we have stopped all irregular crossings at our border during this period of time to ensure that, and it is for non-essential travel, to ensure the safety of Canadians. And those measures have been put in place, and they have been very effective throughout this, and we have undertaken, with our agreement with the United States, to continue these measures until they are no longer required.
Mr. O'Toole.
Mr. Speaker, I'll let Minister Blair take the time between the next sitting to review his first answer and compare it to his second answer. Thousands of small businesses and farms, Mr. Speaker, across the country have been asking their MP to increase the Canada summer jobs. In fact, the Prime Minister suggested there would be more, and they didn't give any more budget to any of the MPs. They announced $9 billion, Mr. Speaker, for students to stay home. Here's a proposal for Team Canada. Cut that in half, $4.5 billion. You can have over 400,000 summer jobs for essential services, for farms, where students will work. And you can still give them a $1,000 tuition credit for half of the cost of their $9 billion plan. When will they step up, like they did with the wage subsidy, realize they got it wrong the first time, and heed our advice to fix it now?
The Honourable Minister.
I thank the member for his question, Mr. Speaker. Our student measures include income support, increased job creation, tuition and Canada student loan enhancement, as well as an opportunity for students to serve. This is what we've heard from student organizations and students across the country. We are not disincentivizing work. We are ensuring that students can pay their bills and can actually continue on with their studies in the fall. With respect to Canada summer jobs, we are creating 70,000 jobs. We added another 76 or 116,000, depending on if you include opportunities to study last week. And we're going to look at what else we can do for students. Thank you.